سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم.
Glory be to Allah, all praise to Allah, there is no God but Allah.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytani rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fast from us as an act of ibadah. Welcome to the program, your program, our program, The Virtuous Woman. And today in the studio, we have honorable personality who is going to do justice to our topic for today. You don't have to bother at all. If you've been following us, you should know that our episodes are always educative and very informative. Please do not go after this short break. We will be right back.
وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم.
المؤمنات organization.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
A group of pious Muslim women upholding the tenet of Al-Islam, premise on Al-Quran and Sunnah of the Holy Prophet. Al-Mu'minat organization's activities include weekly and monthly tarbiyah, a gathering where women are sermonized, house-to-house and mosque-to-mosque dawah, e-vocational training for empowering women, Unity Day, Al-Mu'minat Training Forum, ATF, a camping program where women are taught in line with the dictate of Allah and the Holy Prophet. To be part of this laudable and rewarding project, contact Al-Mu'minat Headquarters at number 1, Thani Olodo Street, Jibowo Bus Stop, Yaba, or send your contributions to the following bank accounts. For more information, call 0802-950-6613 or 0805-531-9534. Al-Mu'minat Organization, the Believing Women.
Welcome aboard, it's still your program. And today, like I mentioned earlier, the topic we are treating is something that everybody really has to benefit from. You know why? I could remember some days ago, I was at a health center and I saw this woman. She was carrying a little baby and she had another older child with her. And she was beating the older one mercilessly. You know, I was wondering if she was actually the mother. And I looked at myself and I began to ask myself, if you actually look at the woman who was beating the baby, the way she's dressed will not even tell you she's a mother. And you know, the next thing she was saying was, Hafiz, get your useless self out of that place. And I was wondering, really, Hafiz and the mother, what kind of values is she actually passing across to this child? You know, that brings me to the topic we are going to be discussing on the show today. Guest in the house is going to be talking to us about the role of Muslima in entrenching moral values. Did you hear me right? The role of a Muslima in entrenching moral values. Call everybody and let them be aware that the program is about to start. Well, in the studio with me today, I have Alhaja Bushro Ali. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Well, you know something about this episode is that it's a kind of collaboration because the guest speaker bears the name as the host. Well, don't worry, I'll give you the details later. So, Alhaja Bushra Ali, she is the Assistant Director of Education. She works with Lagos State Government. And that is to tell you that we couldn't have had a better person to address this topic than someone who is actually in the education sector. She knows what actually these moral values are and the role that Muslim women should actually perform. Well, let's tell those watching us this morning, who is a Muslima and what are moral values?
A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa dahu la sharika la wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma salli ala muhammadin wa sallim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. A Muslima is a Muslim woman that has submitted herself to the will of Almighty Allah. He believes solely in Allah, and he believes that Almighty Allah is the controller of our life. He does not do anything, say anything, or do or act in any way except with the in conjunction with the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that is why this Muslima followed the injunction of Allah, as he told us in Quran 33 verse 36, that it is not befitting for a Muslim man or a woman, when Allah and his Prophet have decided on a matter, that they should have anything to the contrary. So she has submitted herself, and whenever she does anything, she has a reference to it from the Quran or the Sunnah. Okay. And that is who a Muslima is actually is.
Okay.
And another very important word from the topic is moral values. Yes. When you talk about moral values, these are the standard for the good and evil in the society. And when you talk about it, it covers every aspect of human life, whether you are a Muslim, whether you are a non-Muslim. But to a Muslim, moral values are very, very important because it is a universal thing. As a Muslim, you are expected to behave very well. And that is why in many verses of the Quran, they are like twins. When Almighty Allah said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, he always follow it with wa amilu salihat, that all you believe and those who do good deeds. And when you talk about the issue of morals, it's not something that we can overemphasize in Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself said in one of his hadiths that Almighty Allah has sent me to perfect morals. So when you talk about a Muslim is a perfection of morality. So whenever you see a Muslim, you must be expecting the best of behavior coming from him or her. And a Muslim woman as the first school of a child is an embodiment, should be an embodiment of a morality. Because what you don't have, you cannot give.
That's true.
And that's the first thing, that as a Muslim woman who have submitted, you are knowledgeable, you know what is right from what is wrong, and from the basis that you have known, you have been able to distinguish between the two, it makes it possible for you to impact it onto others. And when you look at those people that a Muslima will entrench morality onto, okay, it starts from the children. Because the first school to a child is the mother.
That's true.
And the first contact you have is with that child. So as a Muslim woman, you are expected to be a very good model. Okay. Because most children learn by examples. At times, your children may not even listen to you, but even your mere silence, your movement, your utterances, and your act.
They observe everything.
Yes, they are like computers. They record everything, and by the time they are showing it to you, you'll be embarrassed at times, and you may be highly surprised that the slightest thing that you are doing, these children are actually covering it. So, and that is why as a mother, you need to be very conscious of whatever you are doing. And when we talk about the issue of morality in the society, there are so many aspects that we can look at. Just like I've said, it covers everything about the life of human being. And it extends from local to national. It even extended to international. Because even your relationship with other people across country boils down to morality. And that is why we need to be very conscious. So when we talk about morality, moral values, we can start from the first thing that a Muslim woman must be conscious of in imparting onto the children is that of the belief, firm belief in Almighty Allah, because it's the basis of all morality.
Okay, so now we are beginning to take
those moral values
one after the other.
Okay.
The little that the time can permit us to take, we want to take them one after the other and look at the perspective of Islam on it.
Okay.
When we talk about believing Almighty Allah, it's one of the basis of being a Muslim. And when you look at the pillars of Islam, the articles of faith, they are the both of them, the first thing is believe in Almighty Allah. And they believe in the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So as a Muslim woman, the first thing is to entrench that firm belief in our child or children and make sure that they have that belief in the power of Almighty Allah, that is the one that creates, is the one that will make us to live, is the one that sustains us, and is the one that will eventually kill us. And when we die, it's not the end of our life, it's going to raise us up again to come and give account. Just like Almighty Allah told us in Quran 30 verse 30, He said, "Uwa lezi kolakokun, zuma razakokun, zuma yumitukun, zuma yuhikun." Almighty Allah said, "It is me, Allah, that has created you. I'm the one that is sustaining you. And when the time comes, I will make you to die. And the death is not actually the end of your life. I will make you to rise up again to come and give account." And in that particular verse, Almighty Allah was asking us, who among those people that you associate with me that have the same power as this?
None.
And we all know there is none. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
So we must be able to impact this in the life of our children. And they must be convinced of the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the prophet of Almighty Allah, is our prophet, is somebody, is the ambassador of the truth to us. Is going to be the one that witness for us on Yawm al-Qiyamah.
Okay.
So the first thing is that that firm belief must be in the child, and he must know that wherever he is, Almighty Allah is with him. And that was the lesson Prophet Luqman alayhi salatu wasalam wanted to impact on his son.
Okay.
When he was telling him in Quran 31 verse 13, he said, "Oh my son, I'm commanding you that you should not associate any partner with Almighty Allah.
Okay.
For associating partner with Allah is a transgression."
Please, ma, just before you explain that verse, let's go on this short break. We will be right back.
ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون.
Welcome aboard. It's still your program, The Program, and the topic is the role of a Muslim in entrenching moral values. Alhaj Abushro, you were telling us about Prophet Luqman before we went on that short break. Can you please continue?
Now, just like I was saying before we went on a short break, I was referring to the advice given by Prophet Luqman to his son.
Okay.
Because that is one of the role of a Muslima. You have that role to call your children, call them one-on-one, and let them know that what you want to tell them is a serious thing.
Hmm.
That was what Prophet Luqman did. When he find out that the son has come of age, and the first assignment he gave him was that La tushriku billah, inna shirka la lazulmun hazim. He said, "Oh my son, do not associate any partner with Almighty Allah. For associating partner with Allah is a transgression." So we must make sure that we impact this on our children. And whenever they have this, it acts as a sort of moral guard for them wherever they are.
Okay.
Because when you are conscious of the presence of Almighty Allah, all other moral values just follows like that.
It'll be easy to
adapt.
Okay. Okay.
Because you know, even if there is nobody there, you must behave very well. Because Almighty Allah is omnipresent and omniscient. Then, having talked about the belief in Allah, the next one that is very important is on the issue of truthfulness. Truthfulness is very, very important, because when you talk about truthfulness, is a virtue that Islam does not compromise under any circumstance. And that is why, even in the Quran, Almighty Allah said, La natula ala al-kazibin. He said, may the wrath of Almighty Allah be on the liars. And in Quran 61, verses 2 to 3, Almighty Allah said, A'udhubillahi minash shaitani rajim. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, lima taquluna ma la tafalun, kabura maktan indallahi an taqulu ma la tafalun. Almighty Allah said, oh, you believe, why do you say that which you do not, or you cannot do, or you cannot say? It is a great sin in the sight of Almighty Allah for you to say that or do that or say that that you cannot do. So the first thing that they must say, another thing that we must impact on our children, is for them to forever remain truthful. And this truth will guide them against so many vices, because once they are conscious of the fact that whenever they have done anything, they cannot tell lies,
they really have to speak the truth.
Yes, it will make them to be conscious every time that, oh, if I have to say this, I will be ashamed. Then it will draw them away from all those vices around.
Okay.
So, and when we talk about the truth, the first person to impact this is this Muslima. Because as it happened in the life of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, one day he visited one of his Sahabiyah, those women that are his followers.
Okay.
While he was there, the woman was asking her son, come here, I want to give you something. Then the Prophet asked her, do you have anything to actually offer him? The woman said, yes, I have dates to offer him. Then the Prophet said, I didn't mean you don't have anything. It will have been written down for you that you are telling lies. So, and one thing is that for us, we need to guide against this. Because especially among women, is something that is common among us. Maybe you are going out, your child intended following you. You can just ask the child, go and take your slippers and come and join me. Before the child comes back, you are off.
Okay.
You are teaching the child a very bad thing. And it's telling him or her that he too can go on telling lies. So we must know that if you are going out and your children ask you, mommy, buy me something. If you don't intend to buy anything, tell them I may not buy you anything.
Okay.
If you have a chance, you can buy something for them. But for you to have promised them, you must know it's incumbent on you to buy something for them, or else it will be written down for you as being somebody that is telling lies.
Okay.
And another angle is that many of us, at times you are seeing a visitor from the window. The visitor cannot see you, but you don't intend to attend to him or her.
Okay.
Then you ask one of your children or your child around, oh, that person is coming, just tell him your mommy is not around. It's a way of training him or her to become a perfect liar. So, and as a Muslima, you must know that it's not only your words that matter.
Your
behavior, your actions, and everything that you do go a long way to train your child, especially on those virtues that we are talking about.
Well, at this juncture, I must say that our guest speaker has done a good job telling us the role of a Muslima in entrenching these moral values. She also went ahead to tell us what are the moral values to be entrenched. The question I want to ask is, what are the avenues with which a Muslima can actually, apart from the children in the home, what are the other avenues that we can use to entrench these moral values?
When we look at it, a woman is almost everywhere. When in the house, she's the queen. In the home, she's the manager. And on the street, it is the women that you find there. In the market, the bulk of the people in the market are the women. When you go to offices, when you go to where people are working, as you find the men, you find the women. But you find out that in every place that a Muslima find herself, you are expected to impact positively in them, starting from your home, from your neighbors, from your colleagues in the office, from your mates in the school, from those people that are your colleague where you are working or where you are selling, everywhere, any opportunity you have at any point in time, even in the bus stop, at the parks, even when you are going, maybe you have gone to the school of your child, you have seen, when you see two children playing and you see something wrong, it is incumbent on you to make corrections without actually maiming them or trying to injure them in any way. Just let them know that, oh, once a Muslima is around, is likely to impact positively at everybody around.
Well, I really appreciate that she has been able to let us understand that apart from the fact that entrenching moral values should be our social responsibility, it is also the first assignment of a Muslima for you to know that at every point in time, wherever, whatever situation you find yourself, it is your duty to spread the good moral values. Well, Ma, permit me to ask this question. That, you know, we have quite a number of NGOs, and most often times you find out that they are led by women who actually want to champion a particular cause. In fact, I'm aware of some volunteer groups, you know, who just feel that things has to go right. They champion their cause towards a particular focus. And the cost of this volunteering to make things work right and entrenching moral values, they are likely to come across some challenges. What are the words of encouragement that you can give to people out there whom, you know, who are not being paid for what they are doing, but they are after doing the right thing to actually make moral value the standard of the society?
Actually, one thing is, as a Muslima, you have it at the back of your mind that whatever you do, you are going to be rewarded. So, and that is why in the Quran, Almighty Allah will always tell the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that wa ma alayna illa al-balagul mubin, that it is only incumbent upon you to say it. Whether they follow it or they don't follow it, it should not be your headache.
Okay.
So the first thing is that you should convey the message. Make sure that wherever you are, you make your impact known. And secondly, don't be desperate. That, oh, I've been telling them to do this, they are not doing it. Because there are some people, when you tell them today, immediately they do it. There are so many types of people around. There are some people, immediately when you tell them do this, they do it. That is a category of people. Then there are some, you tell them it takes some time to for them to process it in their minds. So it may take the next 1 month, the next 1 year. And for some, they will go and store it. After storing it, they have to sort. After sorting, they have to process and do all other things. In the sense that even in the next 10 years, you may not see the effect on them. But it doesn't mean that they have not understood what you are telling them. But the only thing is that it has not gotten to the process at which they can
implement it,
whatever you are telling them. So another word of encouragement is that after being fulfilled, that you have conveyed the message, that is the first thing that will make you to be contented, that actually I've conveyed the message. Then the second one is that you must know that no effort of yours have gone wasted. That everything you put in, Almighty Allah is going to reward you. And even if that person is not taking it for now, later in the day, you are still expecting positively. And there are times, even you may talk to the mother, it may be the children that will benefit.
Okay.
The mother will tell you, oh, for me, I'm old now. I may not actually take to what you are telling me, but for my children, I'll make sure they follow everything that you are telling me.
Wow.
And that means your effort has not gone into the drains.
No matter what you do, your efforts have not gone into the drains. Thank you very much, Alhaji Abushra Ali.
Yeah.
At this juncture, we must say that we really appreciate those of you who have been following, and I'm sure you must have learned one or two things. Thank you very much, Ma, for coming around. We really appreciate it. If you enjoyed this episode of our program, join us tomorrow for another interesting episode. I have been your host, Bushra Olagojo Musodiq. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Amantu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wal yawmil akhiri wal qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah wal ba'thi ba'da al maut. لا إله إلا الله. آمنت بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره من الله والبعث
بعد الموت.